Supplying Syrian refugees with much-needed footwear for winter, rushing dog food and metal detectors to Kurdish canine units in Iraq who work alongside U.S. troops. Those are just some of the projects that a nonprofit called Spirit of America is undertaking. The organization is powered by veterans on a mission to support military and diplomatic efforts in hotspots around the world. Josh Brandon, who is the Middle East Project Manager for Spirit of America, is joining us now. Josh, thank you so much for coming in.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So tell us a little bit about what kind of projects Spirit of America does, because this isn't your normal nonprofit.
So I think from the start, Spirit of America provides targeted assistance to support the local partners of U.S. Soldiers and diplomats. So what that means is we kind of fill the gaps where U.S. government resources can't be applied. So I like to break the work down into two major themes so it's easy to understand. The first is providing rapid targeted assistance. And this is your equipment, your training, your experts putting that on a problem to support local U.S. partners. Give me a good example of that. Recently, U.S. Special Operations Forces in Kurdistan contacted me. They had identified the problem that the Peshmerga, the Kurdish militia that they're working with, was having trouble communicating in the fight against ISIS. And so within a matter of like 3 weeks, we were able to determine what kind of radio they could use, get that radio shipped over to them, and then kind of get them back in action.
And that's the kind of thing that maybe doesn't move as quickly when you're talking about the acquisition process and everything with the Pentagon.
That's exactly where we fall in. A lot of times, U.S. government funds can take a year to get some sort of much-needed equipment in there. And because we're completely privately funded, we can get that equipment to our soldiers and diplomats when they need it.
So you are a former Army infantry officer.
Yes.
You spent 10 years in the Army, multiple tours in Iraq. You have a Silver Star, is that right, or two?
Silver Star.
You have a Silver Star and two
Bronze
Stars.
Wrong place, wrong time, but yeah, Silver Star.
And there are many people in your, basically similar to your shoes, they're former military and they're taking their skills to Spirit of America. Why did you decide that this was something you wanted to do?
Yeah, so a little bit of background. After I got out of the military, I worked in the outdoor industry around veteran mental health issues. Got to spend a lot of time mountaineering, like living a really good hippie lifestyle. About 4 or 5 years into it, I started to look around and see like problems in Syria, Iraq, Afghanistan, Central Asia. And I felt that I kind of had a skill set that might be able to help these problems in some form. And so I got back to grad school and found out about Spirit of America through a friend of mine. And what drew me to Spirit of America is it wasn't necessarily going back into service or going into government. I look at them as the future because it's civil society contributing to U.S. foreign policy. And for me, that's moving forward. It's not joining the government or something like that. So
there are dozens of projects that Spirit of America does. I think most people have no idea that this is something that's going on, but they're all over the world. Some of them are specifically tailored to counter Russian influence in other countries. But there's been a lot of focus on the Middle East and U.S. partners there, including the dogs, right, of some U.S. allies. Tell us about that.
The canine project's absolutely one of my favorites. So the background on that is a good friend of mine, an Army officer in Erbil, gave me a call with a problem. And he said there's this fantastic canine unit that's full of explosive and mine detection dogs. They're well trained, but they're not able to operate right now. They need body armor, they need mine detectors, some dog food and dog medicine to keep
them. Dog food, they needed dog food,
yes.
Okay.
And you gotta keep the dogs happy. So within a matter of about a month, we were able to work with the U.S. Forces on the ground, the Peshmerga, to figure out exactly the equipment they need. Then I was able to fly over with the metal detectors, the armor, as well as the food and the medicine to get them operational.
So there is very important expertise that you and others bring to Spirit of America to carry out these projects. But there's also, as I understand it, a bit of a legal hurdle to doing this kind of work because you're doing it very much in tandem with the U.S. military. That's not normal nonprofit stuff. How does Spirit of America navigate that?
So in 2018, we signed an MOU, a Memorandum of Understanding, with the Department of Defense that specifically outlines how we can work with DOD. And additionally, that year, in the 2019 National Defense Authorization Act, we were named as a partner to support the Department of Operations, Department of Defense Operations abroad. And for me personally, that's an excellent document because it gives those diplomats and soldiers on the ground in the midst of the problem, the legal cover that they can come in and we can work with them and, you know, hear their problems and find solutions to support them. So.
And finally, this is the holiday season. And, you know, as someone who I'm sure spent time and important days away from your family, and we sort of think about people who are overseas and they're away from their families, what do you want to remind people?
So I think I'd like to remind them that, you know, for me, Spirit of America is emblematic of citizen service. And so while many citizens serve in many different ways, we can't all really impact U.S. foreign policy or, more importantly, you know, the troops or the diplomats that are out there enacting it. And I'd like them to consider, you know, Spirit of America as a tool for them to kind of demonstrate their civilian service, citizen service, and use us as a tool to actually support and influence that.
Josh, it's such a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time. I appreciate it.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.